everyone. How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. So, welcome to my virtual classroom. In today's session, we will be covering chapter number 13, 31, 33, 35, 36, and 38 chapter of your GK book. So, it's a great place to be here. So, let's start our session. Thank you.
Let's start. Chapter number 13, States and Capital. As you all know, we live in India. So today we are going to learn some states and their capitals in our country. As you can see on the screen, these are some famous tourist places like Taj Mahal, Red Fort, Dal Lake, Golden Temple, Vaishno Devi Temple. Okay, so tell me, are these located in one state of India? No, all these are located in different states. So today, we will learn states and their capitals. Let's start. So the very first is Assam. Assam, it's a northern eastern state of India and its capital is Dispur. The second one is Goa, which is famous for its beaches, and its capital is Panaji. Then the third one is Haryana. Its capital is Chandigarh. Fourth, Jharkhand. Its capital is Ranchi. As you all know, our famous cricketer MS Dhoni, he belongs from Ranchi only. The Ranchi boy. Then the fifth one is Bihar and its capital is none other than Patna. Madhya Pradesh, which short form is MP. Its capital is Bhopal. Nagaland and its capital is Kohima. Then our southern state, Kerala, and its capital is Tiruvananthapuram. Ninth one is Punjab, where Makke di Roti and Sarso da Saag is very famous. And its capital is again Chandigarh. Then the tenth one is Sikkim and its capital is Gangtok. So students, I hope you have learned all these states and capital. And one more thing I want to tell you, that Haryana and Punjab have same capital. That is Chandigarh. So don't get confused whenever the question comes that what is the capital of Haryana and Punjab. It's same, and that is Chandigarh. Thank you. Okay students, now the time for our solar system, which is chapter number 31. So our solar system consists of planets, moon, stars, and many more interesting things. We live on the planet Earth, which is the only planet that has life in our solar system. And do you know the name of our galaxy? So I will tell you, we live in Milky Way galaxy. Now our solar system has 8 planets and a star, the sun, that gives us heat and light. Do you want to know a fun way to remember the names of the planet in the order of their increasing distance from the sun? I will tell you. So you just need to learn. My very educated mother just served us nuts. If you learn this sentence, you will be able to tell the distance of the planets from the sun in their increasing order. Like the very nearest planet to the sun is Mercury, the farthest planet is Neptune. So you just need to learn this sentence. And how will this sentence help you? I will tell you. So as you can see, my very educated mother just served us nuts. The first letter of every word gives you the clue. The hint of the planet's name. As M in my stands for Mercury, then very, here V stands for Venus. Okay? So, if you learn this sentence, you will be able to tell that which planet comes on which number in our solar system. So, let's do the exercise. So, the very first one is Mercury. Because here M stands for only Mercury. Then very, here V stands for Venus. Then educated, here E stands for Earth. Then mother, here M stands for Mars. Just, J for Jupiter. Served, S stands for Saturn. Us, U stands for Uranus, and the nuts, U N stands for Neptune. So, in this way, my very educated mother just served us nuts. Now, let's move on to the page number 47. And now the question is, which was the only country to reach Mars in its first attempt? Do you know? Yes, the country is only India. And which planet is the closest to the sun? Mercury. Okay, so we are done with this chapter. Now I hope you will be able to know the position of all the planets in our solar system. Okay, thank you. So students, now let's do some fun activities. So move on to chapter number 33, that is riddles. You know what riddles are? Riddles are tricky sentences that make us put overthinking caps on to solve them. So this time you have to exercise your brain and put on thinking caps, because I'm going to ask few questions. So the very first is, what goes up but never comes back down? So the answer is age. Second, what has to be broken before you can use it? That's an egg. What word is spelled wrong in every dictionary? That is the only word wrong, because we always spelled it as wrong and pronounce it too. Why did the boy bury his flashlight? Because the batteries were dead. What starts with P, ends with an E, and has thousands of letters inside? That's a post office. Which month has 28 days? I know you all were saying February, but students, every month has 28 days. So, what occurs once in a minute, twice a moment, but never in a thousand years? That's the only word M. So, I hope you have enjoyed these activities. Thank you. So, students, now chapter number 35. Festivals of the world. Festivals are something that everyone enjoys worldwide, right? You have enjoyed, I have enjoyed, and we used to enjoy the festival. It is a time that we wear new clothes, eat so many sweets, and we met our family members. So these are something that brings joy in our life, and it is celebrated worldwide. As you know, festival of color, Holi, hai na? And then festival of light is Diwali, when we burn the crackers and we eat so many sweets, we wear new clothes, we worship goddess Lakshmi and god Ganpati. The Christmas festival, which is very famous in Christians, and it comes in December. Then Eid. So we have different festivals and we have celebrated all the festivals in a different way. So today we are going to learn some new festivals. Okay, so the very first is a festival celebrated in the east of Spain. People throw tomatoes at each other and enjoy playing with each other. So this is a very famous festival, La Tomatina, in east of Spain, where people used to throw tomatoes to each other. Just as we throw colors on Holi, they used to throw tomatoes on each other and enjoy this festival. Then the second one is a Jewish festival, which is also known as the Festival of Lights, similar to Diwali in India. Like we celebrate Diwali in India, other countries people used to celebrate it in the same way, for 8 nights, and a special candle is lit in the special lamp. So this is celebrated for the 8 days, and in this festival people used to light a special lamp, and this festival name is Hanukkah. Then the third one is, you must have know this, celebrated on 25th of December every year to mark the birth of Jesus Christ. And yes, this is none other than Christmas. Then the fourth one is, everyone dresses up in the costumes for the ghost related decorations are done, and this is Halloween. So what people used to do on this, they used to dress up different costumes of ghost, and they have decoration related to that only. Like you can see there's a pumpkin, and the pumpkin has eyes, nose and mouth. So people used to decorate these kinds of things at their home while celebrating this festival, and with this they used to wear, they dressed up themselves according to that only, and this festival is Halloween. So I hope you all have now learned about all these new festivals. Okay, thank you. Okay students, so now it's time for the chapter number 36 about some famous musicians of India. As you all know, there are so many musical instruments like flute, sitar, tabla, harmonium and etc. So we have so many musicians who have done mastery in playing some particular musical instrument, as you can see in the images. Like Ravi Shankar ji, he is a sitar maestro. Hari Prasad Chaurasia is a flute player, and many more. So now in this chapter we will learn some Indian musicians who have played a huge role in popularizing our music across the globe, all over the world. So we have these Hari Prasad Chaurasia, Shiv Kumar Sharma, MS Subbalakshmi, Pandit Ravi Shankar, Bismillah Khan and Zakir Hussain. So the very first one is Hari Prasad Chaurasia ji. He is a famous flute player. Then the second one is Shiv Kumar Sharma. The third one is Miss Subbalakshmi. Pandit Ravi Shankar, who used to play sitar. Bismillah Khan, who is a very well known and famous flute player. And the none other Zakir Hussain. All these are famous for Indian classical music, and they had given a lot of fame to our Indian country and our Indian music. Thank you. So students, now we are on chapter number 38, that is ticking clock. Have you ever heard the sound tick 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 coming from the clock hangs on the wall of your room? So this clock help us to maintain our daily routine, our day-to-day activities. Only because of these we are able to manage our work on time. Like 7 o'clock in the morning, we used to brush our teeth, then we take bath, we worship to God. At 9 o'clock in the morning, we used to eat the breakfast. You know, there are so many activities which we have to manage only with the help of clock. So in this chapter, you have to tell the timing shown by the clock. So let's get started. As you can see in the first one, it's showing the time 3 o'clock, the time when we used to eat our lunch and take a small nap. Then the second one is 4:30, it is showing evening time or maybe in the morning also, because AM and PM is not written here. So let's consider this as PM, the evening time when we used to eat the snacks. Then the 12 o'clock, it can be of midnight when we used to sleep. And the fourth one is 2:45. Let's take this of morning as well when we used to sleep. Now, in the next 4 clocks, you have to draw minute hand or hour hand according to the given time. So, let's do this. The very first one is 5:45. So, while showing 5:45, 1 clock is between 5 and the 6. And the minute hand will be at 9. Then the second one is 11:30. Here minute hand is on 6 and the hour hand will be between 11 and 12. Then the third one is 3 o'clock. Here, 1 o'clock. Here hour hand is at 1 and the minute hand will be at 12. And the last one is 3:25. Here hour hand is at 3 and the minute hand will be at 5. So I have done this too. So we are done with this chapter also, and I hope now you will be able to watch the clock. Thank you.
So I hope you all have enjoyed this session. So we will meet again in the next session. Till then, goodbye. Stay safe. Thank you.